King David is a very important person in the Bible. He was brave, kind, and a great leader. People think he was one of the best kings Israel ever had. David's story starts when he was just a shepherd boy, but something amazing happened. He defeated a giant named Goliath using only a sling and a stone. After that, he became a close advisor to King Saul. And when King Saul passed away, David was chosen as the new king of Israel. He became the most righteous and powerful king they had ever seen. King David had successfully led his armies to many victories and established a prosperous kingdom. However, one spring evening, as David walked upon the roof of his palace, he saw a woman bathing on a nearby rooftop. She was very beautiful. Her name was Bathsheba, and she was the wife of Uriah the Hittite, one of David's loyal soldiers.
Who is this beautiful woman?
Instead of turning away from this temptation, David chose to act upon his sinful desires.
I want you to find everything about that woman. Go now.
Yes, sir. She is Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam and the wife of Uriah the Hittite.
Instead of turning away from this temptation, David chose to act upon his sinful desires.
You go and tell her to come to the palace right now.
Yes, sir.
The next day, Bathsheba came to the palace and met the king in private.
You are so beautiful, my dear Bathsheba.
Thank you, my lord.
David was captivated by Bathsheba's beauty, and desire consumed him. He slept with her, knowing that she was another man's wife. After a few days, Bathsheba sent a word to the king saying, "I am pregnant." In an attempt to conceal his sin, David had an idea.
Send me Uriah the Hittite.
You sent for me, master?
When Uriah came to him, David asked him how his job was and how were the other soldiers.
Go to your house and sleep well.
I cannot do that while my friends are in the battlefield.
Don't worry, I am asking you to.
However, Uriah, a man of honor and integrity, refused to enjoy the comforts of home while his fellow soldiers were still fighting in battle. He slept at the palace entrance instead. David hoped Uriah would sleep with his wife, thus providing a cover for David's transgressions. The next day, David was told that Uriah never went home.
Haven't you just come from a military campaign? Why didn't you go home?
My commander Joab and my lord's men are camped in the open country. How could I go to my house to eat and drink and make love to my wife?
Stay here one more day, and tomorrow I will send you back.
So Uriah remained in Jerusalem that day and the next. At David's invitation, he ate and drank with him, and David made him drunk. But in the evening, Uriah went out to sleep on his mat among his master's servants. He did not go home. David's plan had failed, and in his desperation, he resorted to even darker actions. In the morning, David wrote a letter to Joab and sent it to his commander Joab.
Put Uriah out in front, where the fighting is fiercest. Then withdraw from him, so he will be struck down and die.
Uriah was sent to the fiercest battleground the next day. At the most crucial moment, other soldiers left him in front of the enemy. Uriah valiantly fought, but tragically, he lost his life in the war. When Uriah's wife heard that her husband was dead, she mourned for him. Now, with Uriah out of the way, David took Bathsheba as his wife, and she became one of his many wives. However, God was displeased with David's actions, for he saw the depth of the king's sin. One day, the Lord sent prophet Nathan to David. Nathan confronted David and presented a parable to him.
There were two men in a certain town, one rich, the other poor. The rich man had a very large number of sheep and cattle, but the poor man had nothing except one little ewe lamb that he had bought. He raised it and grew it up with him and his children. It shared his food, drank from his cup. The lamb slept in his arms most of the night. It was like a daughter to him. One day the rich man had a guest visiting him, and he was supposed to prepare a meal. The rich man didn't want to slaughter any of his sheep. Then he saw the poor man's lamb in the next farm. He stole the poor man's lamb and prepared it as a meal for his guest.
David, in his righteous mind as usual, pronounced judgment on the rich man.
The man who did this must die. He must pay for that lamb four times over. He deserves no pity.
Nathan then revealed the truth to David, exposing his sin of adultery and murder.
You are that man. This is what the Lord say to you. I anointed you king over Israel. I gave you all of Israel and Judah. And if all of this has been too little, I would have given you even more. You killed Uriah and took his wife to be your own.
I have sinned against the Lord.
The Lord has taken away your sin. You are not going to die. But because by doing this you have shown utter contempt for the Lord, the son born to you will die.
God, in his infinite mercy, forgave David, but the consequences of his actions remained. Soon, Bathsheba gave birth to a boy. David and Bathsheba were happy for a while, and the boy remained healthy. But one day, the child fell sick. The boy remained ill in spite of getting treated by the best physicians in Israel. David prayed to God for the baby. He fasted and went into his house and stayed there, lying on the ground all night. The elders of David's family came to him and tried to pull him up from the ground, but he refused to get up or to eat food with them. In spite of all his prayers, the baby died on the seventh day.
It's all according to the Lord's will. Calm down.
After a few days, Nathan came to deliver another news from God.
I have good news, David.
Tell me, what is it?
The Lord has spoken to me again. Your wife will give birth to another boy soon. You will call him Solomon.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
David was happy to hear the news. Years later, Solomon would grow up to be one of the wisest kings to ever rule the land of Israel. Although David's sin brought immense pain and sorrow, his story teaches us valuable lessons. It reminds us of the importance of resisting temptation, staying faithful to our commitments, and taking responsibility for our actions. David's repentance also demonstrates the boundless mercy and forgiveness of God, even in the face of grave sins. The story of his affair with Bathsheba would forever be a stain on his legacy, but it served as a reminder for the power of forgiveness and the unwavering love and justice of God.